Merry Christmas, everybody. It's that time of year. And I like to spread a little bit of Christmas joy. And yes, I do have a problem. It's part of my New Year's resolution is to stop with the carbonated beverages because it's kind of making me grow some man tits. We don't want that now, do we? A beautiful face like this needs to be on a Greek sculpture, not a squishy piece of Americana. Now, check this out. I'm gonna do this is already freaking me out. I'm gonna do that Amazon Flex survey because I've been offered to do it multiple times and I've never done it. And I'm pretty sure it's just gonna be this basic, stupid little fucking thing. And I figure, hey, just bring everyone along for the ride and I can ramble, bitch, moan, and complain in the meantime. So, let's do some housekeeping before we get started. I know, I need to get a real banner going, but this right here is the Flex Drivers Union, the Facebook group that I've made, and so far I think it's like 11 members now, but it's really cool. It's just we get up here and we talk and we share pictures and stories and the like, and memes for days. But yeah, so if you want to be a part of it, link in the description down below. It's fantastic. Come on, please join the group. The bigger community we have with louder voices, the more better that we can be a community. Oh, I have 10 new members this week. Oh, that's dope. Anyway. And also, as always, a little bit of TubeBuddy link is also going to be in the description. What is TubeBuddy, in case you haven't heard it before? Or if you guys have heard me say it before and you're like, oh my god, Monty, Mace, Valor, shut up about it. I use it for YouTube analytics. So when I click on a video, I can see the video's analytics and analytics about the channel that it's a part of. So I think it's really fucking awesome. Really, come on. Wow, this is really happening. Okay, let's pause that. And then, so we're with TubeBuddy in. I have no idea what this is about, but okay. Anyway, so this is the kind of shit that you get to see on the video, which is pretty awesome. So it helps me as a professional. I use it, I purchase it each month, and I utilize the professional aspect of it to help my channel. And as part of housekeeping, thank you guys so much. I've been doing well. I'm not saying I'm this top tier YouTuber now or anything like that, but the fact that I've actually been able to make my reach known, and that's all thanks to TubeBuddy, I'm almost at 400 subscribers, which to some people are like, it's just 400 subscribers. Like, no, for me, that is massive. That is huge. Like, my channel has not had this growth in the fucking 11 years that I've been a part of YouTube. So that's all thanks to the fucking community. So I'm almost there. So this is the part where, all the places that tell you how to grow a YouTube channel, they all say, hey, push that motherfucking like button. Well, that's what I'm saying now. Push the fucking subscribe button. And, oh yeah, just quick shout out. Raul Sanchez, if I'm saying that correctly. Apparently, I'm dubbing you as my biggest fan. There was actually a couple other people that are commenting a lot, but I've seen you, you're pretty much on it. So thank you so much for being a part of the community. Thank you for the views and all that jazz. And definitely thank you for the commentary. That's the number one thing I like, is I like the discussion aspect of this. As much as I like creating content and as much as I like, hearing the sound of my own fucking voice, I like so much being able to have a discussion with other people. So now that all that jazz is out of the way, so, Amazon Flex, I'd like to hear from you. In order to improve the Amazon Flex program, we'd like to hear about your experience as a delivery partner. Click the link to participate, the survey, blah, blah, blah. Okay, let's do it. Yes, I have a problem. How satisfied or dissatisfied are you with your overall Amazon Flex program experience? Well, overall, that's interesting. So you're gonna hear me bitch moan and complain about this a lot, but once again, I will say that this comes out of love. I love what they're doing with it, and I love the fact that Amazon doing this allows people like me to, and other people that, to earn extra money this way and all that happy jazz. Overall, I like what they're doing. And yes, I've had a bunch of gripes, I've had a bunch of complaints, but at the end of the day, am I satisfied or dissatisfied? Well, I'm not very satisfied, but I'm not very dissatisfied. So I'm not in the middle. I don't sit on the fence about shit. I would just say satisfied. Please rate your overall experience with. Oh, I gotta be honest, I'm not gonna lie. The app needs a lot of work. I mean, there's constant updates, which I will give them that. There's doing a lot of updates, but the app itself, not focusing on the whole driver support just being a non-existent thing that just so happens to fucking be there. Oh, yeah, so quick side note, little story for you. Today, I was on the phone with driver support and I could not understand anything that the lady was saying. There was kids screaming in the background. Oh my God, Miss Fowler, why were there kids screaming in the background? Well, there was kids screaming in the background because, as I've said before, and as some of you may know, and those of you that don't know, these are essentially work from home jobs that Amazon offers. They save the overhead on having to do call center, like operating a call center. So they just, get these like single moms and shit. And I think I've heard of a guy once or twice, but it's mostly women that partake in these jobs. And there's always kids in the background. There's almost always kids in the background, or the person just fucking woke up, and you can tell that this person was just sleeping. What can the Amazon, driver support? What do you need? But yeah, so she had kids screaming in the background, and it was very difficult. I literally just was like, are those kids in the background? And she's like, they don't matter. What do you need? What's your problem? You need help with this such and such delivery? And I'm like, I'm sorry, I could barely hear you. And I just hung up. Called back, and it was some other hippity person, like, hi, welcome. Thank you so much for calling it. But at least there was no kids in the background, so thank God for that. But yeah, anyway, answer the question, yeah, poor. I really want to say very poor, but there has been some improvements to the app that let it function a little bit better. I don't get as frequent crashes and stuff on it, but overall, it's still pretty fucking shitty. How would you rate your experience at the delivery station? Oof. Well, all right. So the Las Vegas one, I'm just going to go with acceptable on this. I don't think it's horrible. I do think that the warehouse staff could actually be a lot better, honestly. I would say that the bulk of them that I have to experience on a daily basis are adequate. They're doing their jobs, they're helpful, but the small amount of ones that I've dealt with that are really difficult, they seem to kind of play favorites. Like they make friends with other drivers and stuff, and so there's this little bit of a relationship to where they're just a little bit nicer, a little bit more cordial to them than, and they're a little bit shorter with other people and less helpful. Anyway, yeah, so I would just say that the number one thing in the Las Vegas area is to basically get all the people in the warehouse on the same page, get them acting a little bit more professional, and kind of clear lines of communication with them and us, the driver, which I think would actually go a long way. But for the most part, the Las Vegas area is it's pretty decent. That's the only one I have to compare it to, obviously, but for what it's, what the hell am I doing? Oh my God. Wow, I don't want to be looking at my mug this whole time. Sorry about that. Okay, so next. How likely are you to recommend delivering with Amazon Flex to a friend, family member, or colleague? Oof. Do I really need that competition? Fuck no. All right, well, how would I? It would really honestly depend on their situation, right? But like, let's just say, like, hey, oh, you're looking to earn some extra money, but not, just some extra side money, but nothing like crazy. Okay, yeah, for that person, I would probably say, yeah, this is something you might want to check out. But, to a friend or colleague, more so than a family member, I actually give a shit about my family and my friends, and I do care about my friends, but, I would say a six. I think a six is fair. I mean, it's some, definitely an avenue based upon people's situations. It's definitely a good avenue to go through. Obviously, unlike with DoorDash and stuff, you know, you're going picking up something, and you're going up and dropping it off. This, you're just getting everything at once, and then you're running around driving, dropping shit off, and you know, it's different from other platforms, but I do say that the differences are actually benefits. I do like that I go to the warehouse and then I'm gone, and then everything's there, and I just drop it off unless there's an issue and I have to fucking handle it then. But for the most part, yeah. Yeah, so I'd say six. I mean, really, it just comes down to, you know, people's own situations, I would say, and how it would fit most likely into their lives. But I would probably say at least 60% of the time I would mention, like, hey, man, you might want to check this out. Really? Okay, so sorry to hear that. Can you please tell us why you gave that score? I believe that currently the form has a lot of room for growth. So stupid, Zach. I believe that currently the platform is long. Oh, okay, well then that's. Thank you for dying to answer. Your response has been recorded. And that's. Is that it? I guess that's it. So that's that. Wow. Okay, so yeah, this is. Unlike the other videos, this is not really me sitting down talking about one particular subject. This is just me kind of going off the cusp. So thank you all for coming by. Thank you guys so much for the growth of my channel. It fucking means the world to me. And, you know. I couldn't be here without you guys, so thank you guys so much. Thank you for the commenters, thank you for the likes, thank you for the subscriptions, and you know, definitely if you're interested in interacting with me more, definitely hit up the Facebook group. I guess my potty mouth has gathered a fan base. Oh, fucking no. But like I said, you guys are the ones that fucking rock, and I am not an expert when it comes to this Amazon shit. I'm just like all of you guys, I'm kind of figuring it out as we go along, and the number one way to do that is to do it as a community. Anyway, this has been interesting, has it not? Mace Valor, signing the fuck.